Today we're going to do a quick walkthrough of the brand new Ninja Foodi Grill. This is the XL. It's the 6-in-1, which means that there's 6 different features that you can use, different functionality put together, built into the grill for using it for a variety of applications. As you can see here, I'll go through the applications. I haven't even powered this thing on yet. I mean, it's plugged in, but I haven't run it through any cycles. So I've literally it's just been unboxed and, kind of doing a first walkthrough. So the first thing you see here is air crisp, which the Foodi Grill does an amazing job as an air fryer. It's powerful. It doesn't throw off excessive heat. It's great if you don't want to heat up your kitchen. The roast function, looks like I just pressed that button, and it's automatically going to 350. So I don't know the difference between roast and bake, and air crisp, but I have to think that it has to do with the, speed of the fan. And, I would guess that the roasting would probably be slightly more speed. Like if you actually did have, something like a pork loin that you put in there, it would promote browning on the exterior, where bake, on the other hand, let's say that you're doing something like brownies or a loose batter, like a cake mix. I'm going to just guess here that the fan speed is going to be lower so that it doesn't get any ripples from the fan blowing the batter around before it sets. Okay, so air crisp, roast, here's grill, which this is the Ninja Foodi Grill. That's going to be a really fun function. Bake, as I showed before, broil, and then also dehydrate. So right out of the gate, I mean, we're seeing that this thing has got a whole mess of functions. And I know because I've used this product before that it has some smart technology built in. Actually, on the side here, there is a thermometer probe. That comes with the unit. Again, I just unboxed this, so I haven't tried any of it yet. But it fits right on the side of the Ninja Foodi Grill, and what that does is it will sense the temperature of the food, and it helps you determine based on your desired doneness how well, medium well, rare, medium rare, your food is going to come out, and it's really a neat feature. Let's take a peek on the inside of this. So right now I have it set up with the grill plate. So this is a similar grill plate to the original Ninja Foodi Grill, but it's basically twice the size. It doesn't take much looking at it to realize how much more capacity this thing has over the original Foodi Grill. If we look up towards the fan, you can still see that there's a splash guard up there, and that's the heating element where the heat comes from. That's your grill plate. So I'm gonna go ahead and take the grill plate out, set it down. Maybe you see a little bit better here on the countertop. Like I said, it has that same cyclonic pattern to it, which is something that the engineers at Ninja have come up with for, I suppose, better browning and airflow. And then we have this fry basket, which is for air frying, which again is about twice the capacity of the original one. So I happen to love this unit as an air fryer. It's unbelievable for reheating food. I mean, I'm speaking of the original Foodi Grill. So I don't know why with this extra capacity, it's not just going to unlock so many more doors. And then the final thing that I wanted to point out was the actual cooking tray itself. So that's without the tray. I'm putting the tray in. I don't have a measurement tape on it. I'll measure it at some point, but it's looking like maybe every bit of 8 or 9 by 14. Now there are some wells on the inside, and that helps the component, the other components, the grill and the fry basket, fit in there the way that they're supposed to, the way it's designed. But you could definitely do a nice cake or some brownies, and it's just going to be interesting to see how this thing works out. So I'm going to put the grill plate back in, shut this thing down, and we'll fire it up for some cooking this evening.